dawning of a new era. The era of Lucha Libre. This revolution will be televised and shall be known as Viva la Lucha.
Presents Viva la Lucha right here in Arena Mexico, in Mexico City, Mexico. We're gonna kick things off with an 8-man battle royale, number one contendership opportunity for the SPW2K Internet Championship. Sergio Santos, Rocco Ramon, Evan Reynolds, Mason Brooks, Aldo Garcia, Toros, Nicholas Panatelli, and Benito Ventura, they're all gonna be competing in an 8-man over the top rope battle royale. Rocky Ramon usually is the homegirl talent at a Super Lucha Libre, so this is gonna be an awkward kind of situation for him, going against and stepping in to the ring of a competing promotion here in Mexico City, FMLL. So this will be interesting to see how the talent of FMLL treat him after they've gone years and years at neck and at war with Super Lucha Libre. Tonight, Rocky Ramon will be representing SPW2K. We're gonna see who's the first entrant to this battle royale matchup. Some of the SPW2K talent, like I said, have competed here in Arena Mexico before. And here, perfect example of one time that's been in Arena Mexico. It's kind of like a homecoming for him. Roddy, formerly known as Roddy, Sergio Santos is back in Arena Mexico, Mexico City. As SPW2K talent, a homegrown SPW2K talent, he's worked throughout FMLL, grown and tiered his talent throughout Mexico City and throughout the South America lines as he coasted through, right through North America and claimed the fame internationally, where he gained multiple tag team championship wins under the name Roddy as part of the Bloodhound Gang tag team with Kaz Bison. Now going back to his original roots, Sergio Santos is looking for that singles breakout startup here in SPW2K and a whole new season for us as we counter out and end off the 2K18 season and enter in the 2K19 season. Sergio Santos would like to enter in the 2K19 season with a big win and that number one contendership opportunity, potentially cash in at our finale episode at Adrenaline. Compete against the current champion, Trey Jeter, who we'll see in action later on tonight. In our main event, with Sergio Santos gearing up to become the future number one contender for the SPW2K Internet Championship. Being the first man entering in, we see this jam-packed Arena Mexico crowd awaiting the arrival of our second entrant. Aldo Garcia of FMLL fame. He's patterned his in-ring ability of the likes of Ricky the Dragon Steamboat and various legends of the past. You see Aldo Garcia going to war with the crowd. Aldo Garcia wants to ascend himself on an international platform. This is the opportunity right here at Viva La Lucha. I'd like to thank you all for tuning in. Like, subscribe, and follow along the journey and all the action of SPW2K Supreme Pro Wrestling action right here on this channel. Also, hit up the Empire Wrestling Network main channel, where you can catch the likes at IFW, AWM, Ref Pro, FZW, OWF, Loaded Wrestling, a whole loaded channel of car wrestling action. And here we have it, Rocky Ramone. And you hear the crowd here in Arena Mexico erupting. Rocky Ramone is back in Mexico City. The Brazilian native has came to Mexico. He was under the tutelage of Vampiro during his time out here. And he traveled across various promotions throughout Mexico and South America. Who is part of the Super Lucha Libre brand. A brand that is a complete alternative and a great war with FMLL and various other Mexican promotions. Luchador promotions out here in South America. And Rocky Ramone, wearing now the SPW2K badge, being a homegrown talent on SPW2K. Here in Arena Mexico for the first time, repping SPW2K on his back, competing in an interpromotional competition. We'd like to thank the whole team at FMLL for having to do this collab with us, bringing us in, hosting SPW2K action with Viva La Lucha. A five-match card here tonight, stacked with action. AC Rocky Ramone is ready and willing. He's had close calls with the SPW2K Pure Championship and the SPW2K Internet Championship. He's just trying to close out, but this man, Cordero, charging down. Yeah, charging down the rampway, FMLL superstar. Future legend here in the Lucha Libre scene. Cordero's a heavyweight luchador. He's a brawler that can fly with the best of them. And you put him to the test. It's going to be interesting to see these guys go to work. And you have to put both feet to the floor to eliminate your opponents. How are they going to orchestrate and use this ring to their abilities? All being Madrid is luchador and have that luchador hybrid high flank style and mechanism to their arsenal. But being the brute and brawler that he is, he has the weight advantage over most of the talent here. As we read our next entrant. Pain, I know your name. This man is the fire starter. He's the young gun. A talent you have to keep your eyes on. Throughout the ending of this 2K8 season and as we enter into 2K19 season, Evan Reynolds, a talent that also competed for the Destiny Championship Series tournament and was hella impressive, the fire starter. He's making his way along the SPW2K brand. Now becoming a reoccurring face here on the SPW2K roster. This young gunner. This young fire starter, Evan Reynolds, is looking to capitalize on a big moment where he can become a singles champion, a bona fide singles champion. His vision is clear, his goal right now is to be put up in some sort of position for some championship goal, whether it's the Pure Championship or this Internet Championship, or luckily get that World Championship opportunity. It's all talents throughout the car wrestling scene would like. We are the face of the promotion, but Evan Reynolds here tonight has an opportunity to secure a number one contendership opportunity in the SPW2K Internet Championship with the adrenaline, both part of the Supreme Fest event. Recall All-Stars. The number one contending here tonight, the winning here tonight is Battle Royale matchup. We'll get that opportunity to compete for the gold at SPW 2K Internet Championship. Either a finale at the Adrenaline or Supreme Fest. That will be yet to be booked. But a number one contendership opportunity is going to be secured in the conclusion of this matchup in the pompous, rich, and elegant Nicholas Panadelaria. Embracing our SPW2K talents as we await the following entrant. Nicholas watching on. Here we have Destiny Championship Series finalist Mason Brooks, the Instant Classic. Can create an Instant Classic performance here tonight and become a number one contender. Mason Brooks has signed on to the SPW2K roster. Agreed to be part of this tour just like Evan Reynolds has. And Rocky Ramon and Sergio Santos have. Looking at the opportunity to compete in Mexico. The FML talent create an international platform for their name and their profile for the SPW2K Internet Championship. Mason Brooks was a finalist and he came on to the losing end with Moses, who ended up defeating Mason Brooks and Scott Adams in the final of the Destiny Championship tournament. That does not stop Mason Brooks, as he has all the tools that it takes to be a huge star. But this man, Benito Ventura, FML All-Star, can finesse a huge win here tonight and get him a ticket to North America, back to Toronto, in the Phoenix Concert Hall for our finale, Adrenaline, Season 4. Sergio Santos, and damn, he started off on fire. Rocky Ramon scores a huge elimination, eliminating Nicholas just like that. And Nicholas, the embarrassment of the Aristocat, being eliminated just like that. Mason Brooks embracing the crowd, soaking up, being the odd man in. He has that opportunity of closing in and double teaming on any one of these attacks. Aldo Garcia leaving Altaro. And Benito Ventura was going to close it off on Rocky Ramon's high. And bring him to an all-time no with that elimination, but he drops in that Samoan drop. Bad drop. Rob Cabron closing himself smart into the corner. Sergio Santos, Mason Brooks, Cordero, really carrying the rate on their side, being more the heavyweights in this battle royale. Benito Ventura being that more that middleweight light heavyweight out of the group. Everyone else is more of a high fly hybrid talent, lightweight talent. So they're gonna have to use their agility and speed to go against some of these heavyweights. That they're doing working in this matchup. Benito Ventura trying to eliminate Aldo like that. No. So much different characters you're gonna see and gimmicks you're gonna see throughout this night. With your luchadors and international stars and legends alike throughout the Empire Wrestling Network and the car wrestling scene. And Rocky Ramon, just like that, it all ends. Rocky Ramon kicked off this battle royal with elimination, and he gets eliminated by Sergio Santos. Sergio using his power and his weight to his advantage, that back body toss, sending Rocky Ramon flying over to the floor through the rampway and eliminating Rocky Ramon early. Rocky Ramon being the second man eliminating this matchup. Evan Randall's closing in under the rope and is smart. Benito and Rocky Ramon having that smart strategy to catch their breath under the rope, half in, halfway out. Make it a lot more challenging for talents like Mason Brooks to work on, but Mason stomping in the gut. Not bringing in Evan Reynolds to slow that in. And oh man, that spin kick. Mason and Evan Reynolds. Two talents to watch. New additions to the SPW2K roster. And oh, that spine buster. Right to the spine. Evan Reynolds. And look at this. Toro has Sergio Santos. Sergio Santos, who just got an elimination. Rocky Ramon has just been eliminated by Toro. And this Brahma Bull has just got a huge elimination of Sergio Santos, cutting off Sergio Santos' big elimination off. And Evan Reynolds has been eliminated by Mason Brooks, the instant classic, the only SPW2K talent left in this battle royale against FMLL stars alike. And Evan Reynolds, you see the frustration. They're the final two SPW2K talents left in this battle royale. Aldo Garcia may be eliminated by Nito. No, not to that advantage. Toro now. Toro and Benito squaring off. Look at that standoff. And Benito was frustrated. And Toro with a power driver spiking Benito on his head. And the odds are in the favor for FMLL to kick off the night with a big win over SPW2K. And now Toro eliminates Benito. Ventura eliminates a fellow FMLL talent roster member on his pathway to becoming a new number one contender for the SPW2K Internet Championship. Mason Brooks just kicked the head off of Aldo and now capitalizing on Toro, who Toro has the most eliminations in this matchup. Mason Brooks sends Toro to the outside. Mason Brooks is scoring elimination, and he does. He eliminates Toro. And this can be an instant classic moment for Mason Brooks here tonight. Mason Brooks, Aldo going at it. Mason with the combination, rights, lefts, lefts and rights. Toro been eliminated, being sent to the back. Aldo reversing it, sends Mason over the top rope. Mason trying to skin the cat, but to no avail. Aldo Garcia cuts it off for Mason Brooks. And Mason Brooks again, he takes another L. Man, what a performance. And we look at some of the highlights of this matchup. Aldo Garcia walks out with a number one contendership opportunity. And we're gonna make it happen. Aldo Garcia got his ticket to the finale of Adrenaline. He will meet Trey Jeter from the SPW2K Internet Championship. Congrats to Aldo Garcia and the FMLL star. Man, big win. And we just getting started right here on Viva La Lucha. We're going to have a championship showcase. Coastal Najib, the SPW2K Pure Champion, versus Astro Dynamico, the FML World Cruiserweight Champion. And this is going to be a clash, a wonderful clash between great styles, the pure wrestling style, the pure wrestling hybrid style that we love to embrace in SPW2K, where you have to be an all-around wrestler. You cannot adapt to just one style, one skill set, one-dimensional wrestler. No, you have to be a high flyer. You have to be able to tame high flyers. You have to get in there and be technical. You have to brawl with the best of them. And hell, if you get to a hardcore, unpure atmosphere, you have to be able to tame that too. And Colson at Jeep, scoring a huge victory and retaining the championship, defeating Pac at Heatwave. Colson Ajit got his ticket to Mexico City and Arena of Mexico to face Astro Dynamico for this clash between two historic championships, the illustrious, prestigious championships. As the World Cruiserweight Champion, Astro Dynamico, a fucking highlight reel, a human highlight reel in his own right. You're gonna witness it here tonight, where we see the tail of the tape between Colson Ajit, Astro Dynamico, Colson Ajit, has toured throughout Mexico City before. As we gear up for this clash, this showcase between the championships here in Mexico City, Mexico. Viva la Lucha Championship Showcase. Sorry, the Viva La Lucha Championship Showcase begins right now. I'm stumbling over my words, man, because I'm excited, so excited. DJ E right here, the SPW2K president, and the host of SPW2K calling the action as you see Coastal Najee making his entrance. The pure champion, Coastal. Watching on this jam-packed arena in Mexico. The Pure Championship, the beautiful, prestigious SPW2K Pure Championship title can be put up in this showcase of champions. Colson Ajit won that SPW2K Pure Championship at the Destiny Championship Series finale, night 4, in that fatal 4-way matchup. Where Pac defended it as a surprise, beautiful matchup where you see Pac, Kevin Reynolds, Jesse Snipes, and Colson Ajit. They ran out to war. Colson Ajit pinned a fallen Jesse Snipes with a split leg of the Raven Russo. They gained him that big victory to become the SPW2K Pure Champion. He went on to defend it at SPW2K Heatwave. He successfully, clearly successfully defended it. And put an alright shoot right against Pac in that big rematch. Pac had his rematch clause. Failed to retain the championship and reclaim the championship. Now Pac is in Japan, goes on his hand in Mexico, defending the Pure Championship once again. Here's another challenger, this time a fellow champion in his own right, a man that has a highlight reel of performances throughout here in Arena Mexico as the FMLL World Cruiserweight Champion. Astro Dynamico is here, ladies and gentlemen. The FML World Cruiserweight Champion, Astro Dynamico, on his charge as he sprints his way down and flies in the Viva La Lucha ring. Dynamico, Colson Ajit, the championship showcase begins right now as they lock it up. Colson Ajit forcing Astro Dynamico back into the corner, holding him back, working him in that corner. Astro Dynamico now locking it back up. Now, wrenching on that arm. Colson needs to ground and keep Astro Dynamico down on the mat as best as possible. Close him from getting that speed. Astrodynamic is one of the fastest luchadors throughout this FMLL roster. And damn near, I can say he could probably be one of the fastest luchadors up there in the whole car wrestling scene. And Cole Stone needs to maintain this control. He has a height and weight advantage over Astrodynamic, as you see that beautiful cartwheel moonsault showcasing some of his aerial arsenal. Cole Stone is going to go upstairs. Astro. Oh, eats that senton. Also maintaining control. And no, oh, Hurricane Rana. I thought Astro was going to reverse that some way, somehow. But no, he does with that head kick. And Astro in control, that Irish whip into the corner. Oh, stomp to the gut. No. Dragon screw whipping that knee. Lord, I need that way. And oh, look at that. Snap suplex into the mat. The thin padding here in Arena Mexico. And look, look at Astro's gonna fly. Astro perched up and he drops those knees. Jesus Christ. A dangerous angel wing. Meteor Warrior dropping those knees right into the legs. And oh, barrel tap. Cyclone over the top rope, cross body to the floor. And here we go, Astrodynamico's gonna start cooking up, sending Colson into the corner, pounding him down. Astrodynamico now getting back inside the ring, in charge, getting the fans behind him. Colson now slides in to break that count out. 15-second count out. Astro's gonna fly. Soaring is scoring. Oh my God. El Capo Calido hitting it. Picture perfect. Look at this. What is this? Astro. Oh, I thought he was gonna go. Bounce. Nope. Arm drag. Post on back in control now. Astro just creating a highlight reel performance already in the early going of this matchup as he was in control. No, quick as he avoids that kick to the back. And now Cole Stone miscalculating and he eats that Hurricanrana. Astro's back perched up on the turnbuckle. He drops another angel ring meteor, dropping those knees. And what is this? Oh my God! 450 splash! Beautifully done! From the top rope to the floor, just imploding into the midsection of Colson, that Jeep, knocking the wind right out of it. And oh, sending Colson into the post. And the FMLL star Astrodynamico, the FMLL World Cruiserweight Champion, Astrodynamico, maybe putting that FMLL World Cruiserweight Championship back on the map on an international scale with this huge performance. We may be seeing that FMLL World Championship really get some World Championship bookings. Cruiserweight Championship get some bookings internationally. This type of performance, you never know. You may see Astro in UK, you may see Astro in Japan, you may see Astro do a fucking tour with us with SPW2K, defend that Cruiserweight Championship with this type of performance. Astro is on fire, and he DDTs Cold Stone right into the mat. Cold Stone clashing with Astro here right now for the first time ever, and oh, he missed that. As Cold Stone pulls back on the rope, avoiding that slingshot, that springboard, another Hurricanrana moonsault. And Cold Stone back in charge. Oh, drop kick right to the face. And no, he gets dropped by Asher, but back into an arm drag. Corona again to Ash Dinamico. And you know, he's feeling the hurt from the splashes, from the meteor drops to the gut. And oh, Asher with that unprotected elbow, catching it right into the face, busting Cold Stone right open. Cold Stone's bleeding. The scar tissue on his head from the years of constant hardcore death matches in his time throughout Japan and here in Mexico, violent wars that Cold Stone has competed in, even in the death matches he competed in here in SPW2K. He has that scar tissue on his forehead, making it easy to be busted open. And Ash was taking advantage of that springboard bulldog drop, face buster. And a bloodied Cold Stone. And a championship showcase like this, you want to get a huge win. It brings the prestige of the championship that you're holding, that you're defending here tonight. You're defending the prestige. You may not be defending it in a sense of a championship matchup, but you're defending it in the showcase of its prestige. The prestige level is on the line in a matchup like this, where the whole world is watching right here on YouTube or Twitch, Premiere. If you're watching live, we'd like to thank you. Subscribe, like, keep in touch with the action. And we're gonna see Asher fly. No, Jesus. Oh my God, suicide dive through the turnbuckle into a tornado DDT. Jesus. God bless Asher Dinamico. Asher Dinamico, can I get that count out? Or just let Cold Stone relish in the embarrassment of that maneuver? What is this, Astro? Nope, perched up in the turnbuckle. He got caught. Colston sending Astro into the ropes now. Sending him upstairs. Attack to the back. Oh, and that bell to back. Underarm hook. Release out of the turnbuckle. Astro Dinamico now spinning around that leg. Irish whip to the rope, clothesline. Asher's back in control. And Asher just trying to see. He sees Cold Stone is moving, and oh, he took the chance anyways. He didn't want to go for the running dive because he knew Cold Stone was moving around. He tried to think if he can get for that middle rope, Swanton, step rope, Swanton, but missed it. Colton's now in control, and oh, that underarm hook, famous sir. Just crushing his face under the pressure of his leg. Into the mat, the unprotected mat there. Leg drop on the arm, Asher Dinamico. Astro Dinamico. Now sending Cold Stone back inside the ring. Oh, kick to the gut. No, Cold Stone stops that attack. No! Astro showcasing some strength that he has. Unorthodox strength he has for his stature. With that powerball reversal. And Astro, what are you doing? Oh my God. What is this? Astro pushed up. Look at the balance. Middle rope. Inside suplex, look at this middle row superplex from the outside to the inside of the ring, dropping Cold Stone. Oh my God, Asher Dinamico is putting his all in this matchup. Asher's upstairs, and oh, 450, but no one's home. Empty pool. He crashed and burned. And this is where Cold Stone's gonna capitalize. A reverse DDT and a spin out leg drop. Another spin out leg drop. He's trying to land on his throat. cut off that ear supply. And oh, Asher with that chop block to the throat. He got stopped, and look at this. Oh, STF. STF, he's cinching it in. Oh my God. Look at the twerk on the knee. Look at the twerk on the knee. But Astro. Oh, sends that elbow to the face. That open wound. Astro now sending Colson into the turnbuckle. What a showcase. Championship showcase between these two men. Astro just showcasing the aerial assault. While Colson has just been a brute force. And oh, that springboard. Splash. That midsection has been banged up all match. The ref checking in. And Asher, you're taking up too much time pandering to the crowd right there. And I think he's waiting. Oh, I guess he's just waiting to line up Colson for that shot. Laying him out right there. And Astro, if I was Astro, I'd close in on the pinning predicament right now and close off this matchup. You showcased and out-wrestled Colston pretty much all match long. And this is it. There it is. The 450, he hit it. And you see the pain. The pain thriving throughout the ribs. They've been attacked throughout this whole matchup. Goldstone is out, but Astro is not done, and I think he should have went for the pin right there. Astro, you cannot underestimate Goldstone. And the ref checking on Goldstone at G. He could be hurt. Colston, I don't know if he's playing possum or what. Oh, he is. Oh my God, Colston. Colston taking advantage. Oh man, spin out DDT. Colston just psychologically out wrestling him now at this point. You know he can't keep up to speed and agility with him. So he's gonna use psychology and he's gonna outwit him, bust it up and all. Colston still has fight. You count out last. Count Colston at G. This guy's fighting in wars, battles. Colston at G is one of the most violent talents in this industry. And he's taking advantage of a moment right there. He knew Ash was playing possum. So he took his time. Spiked with that packet power driver. Now breaking down on the arms. And working on the limbs, limb by limb, cutting them off. Oh. With a vicious stomp to the chest to Astro. And Colston. What is Colston have set up? Colston with a power bomb. And he's holding him down. Folding him up for the pin. One, two. No, he's gonna flip it over. Flip it over into that tamer. And he's gonna work on the back. Break down Asher Dinamico. And slow him down completely. And Asher hooking the leg to try and get some sort of release. But the damage has been done. And Colston is looking to capitalize. Colston with a Hurricanrana out of the corner. He's been using that Hurricanrana to create space, create openings. And now look at this, Colston hooking the legs and hooking his legs on the rope as well. One, two, and oh. Oh, he did it! How did Rev not see that? Colston at G just stole this one. Why the ref not catch that? Colston hit the legs, got the extra leverage on the ropes. And the ref watching and making sure the arms were on the mat. And the shoulder to the mat, not paying attention to Coco's pacing on his legs. Coco got the pin. And this is an SPW2K ground. This is FMLL. It's not like I can restart this. Coco gets the win over here.
Fireform.
And just like that, we're going into the six-man tag team championship opportunity. The rematch. Lucha Native International this rematch called
Abundance in bundles,
right here at troubles, home.
Towers and tunnels,
views and valleys, waves and streets. You from Nico sun, Vega, planet Earth, Lucha
and
Native.
Ain't scared of no Mars.
Do not have Chavo Guerrero due to Chavo Guerrero being injured, suffering a concussion at the hands of a mystery assailant that's been hired at the hands of Norgos Mafia, who defeated the Lucha Natives at Heatwave for the six-man tag team championship. Defeated the Lucha Natives through the sun, Rey Mysterio, to be a part of the team, a one-off tag team. The Rey Mysterio and the Lucha Natives, unfortunately, they could not retain the SPW2K six-man tag team championship. But Norgos Mafia will walk on with the win at Heatwave. They meet again. Here, filling in the void of Chavo Guerrero, we have Rey Velez from FNL. And Rey, the electrifying luchador. Stepping up to the plate, representing FMLL, teaming up with fellow FMLL talents, Apache Guerrero and Nico Vega, who's done his tours throughout Mexico City. This is where Nico Vega got his start, broke his wings, where he got scouted to be part of SPW2K. Let's hear it. Beautiful connection, a lucha libre. Luchadors alike, representing both SPW2K and FMLL, as they will go to war against the SPW2K, the new SPW2K six-man tag team champions, Norgos Mafia, the second ever SPW2K six-man tag team champions, Norgos Mafia, being led by Mikey Truth. You got the big man, the mobster, Frankie the Mobster Graziano, right by Mikey Truth, by him right there, the big man. And in that Norgos Mafia fly trench coat, we got the golden boy, Shane Ashton, the right-hand man, the cousin of Mikey Truth, Shane Ashton. The man that sparked this huge feud between the Lucha Native and Norgos Mafia. This little feud started out in the Destiny Championship Series tournament when Shane Ashton was eliminated. I see Mikey Truth there showcasing that six-man, that beautiful six-man tag team championship. Shane Ashton there. Sick-ass Norgos Mafia trench coat, gonna catch that merch. And look at that alignment of Norgos Mafia. Like I said, this feud all started out from Destiny Championship Series tournament night two. In the main event of night two, the finals of round one, it was Apache and Shane Ashton that locked it up, and the bell has sounded, and this matchup kicks off. Apache gaining the upper advantage like he did at the Destiny Championship Series tournament, where he eliminated Shane Ashton in the first round. Many were saying it was an upset, but Apache Guerrero has all the tools and skills to be a top star, a future SPW2K world champion if he ever wanted to focus and put his energy into a heavy singles run. Apache Guerrero can do that. But Apache Guerrero teamed up with Nico Vega and Chavo Guerrero to form the Lucha Natives. And during that path, they competed in the six-man tag team tournament where they were successful and became the first ever six-man tag team champions. The Lucha Natives did. Shane Ash not having the upper advantage over Apache, which he thought he did at the finale, in that six-man tag finale at Destiny Championship Series, where it's SPW2K versus the World, led by Apache Guerrero, representing Worldwide Wrestling, teaming up with Taiga Aoki. Apache Guerrero scored that pinfall over Shane Ashton, which fueled this feud even more. Shane Ashton saying that Apache is not the better man or the better wrestler than he is. And he's out to prove that fact. And he's gonna have the team, his gang, his mafia, take that glorious SPW2K six-man tag team championship. As I'm stumbling over my words here tonight, has been action-packed since the start of the show. Shane Ash is sending Apache back in that corner, and it's been back and forth between these two men. Apache, that scorpion death drop to Shane Ashton. This is the return matchup, the rematch. Lucha Natives, the first ever six-man tag team champions, against the second ever six-man tag team champions, that being No More Mafia. And Mikey Truth has been tagged in, the two cousins exchanging that tag. Mikey Truth is now in, former SPW2K world champion, with that springboard frog splash, Odie to Eddie Guerrero over Apache Guerrero. Insult to injury, what they did to injure Chavo Guerrero at Heat Wave prior to their matchup, their championship matchup. And Apache with the weight and heavy height advantage over Mikey Truth. Gonna just manhandle Mikey Truth. Look at this. Oh man, Black Hole Slam variation. Just crushing Mikey Truth right there. And this is a Lucha Libre rules. So it's 2 out of 3 falls. So we're gonna add you, whether it's the first pinfall or submission, the bell will ring and then it'll ring again. No, you won't be seeing any graphics, special graphics. This is the original way of six-man tag team matches here in Mexico. It was only right, the Lucha Natives. Oh my God, get that ruling. I see Apache Guerrero just encompass the body of Mikey Truth with that swanton. 2-0, Mikey kicks out. Apache fails to get that first pinfall. In the early going of this 30 minute. 2 out of 3 falls. Lucha Libre rules matchup for the SPW2K six-man tag team championship. The only right rim arena in Mexico, Mexico City, we bring it back to its roots. The right way six-man tag team championship matchup should be done and all. Man, that stomp. That hangman stomp. Having Apache Guerrero lay down. You see Mikey Truth allowing Apache to tag in Nico Vega. Oh man, and Mikey just stopped that Superman punch. Jeez, stopping that Superman punch, spin around. Skull crusher straight to the knee. And Mikey Truth has the freakish strength for his size. He's gone to war with some of the most talented athletes, talented card talent throughout the Empire Wrestling Network. Legends alike of EK Fear, Trans 9, Countdown, Super Loco, Big Money, Magic T, legends that build the pillar of the Empire Wrestling Network. Mike has wrestled with them into the new generation of talent. You see Rayo, that float over splash, almost scoring that first pinfall for the team. As Mikey has transcended eras of the Empire Wrestling Network and has remained one of the most top international talents for the Empire Wrestling Network. Rayo setting up Mikey Truth with that tornado DDT. Rayo, one of the most electrifying cruiserweights in the scene today and throughout Mexico, making an international splash on Mikey Truth. Oh man, with that lightning strike splash right there, Red Arrow variation. Beautifully done, the height, the control he had over on that, and spiking right onto Mikey Truth. It's Mikey Truth now on. Mikey Truth knows deep down inside that Rayo is faster than him, so he's gonna ground him with that kill switch, face of greatness, maneuver, and he's gonna set up Rayo. Oh, he's gonna set up Rayo for the Truthful Injection. Is that what you're gonna see right here? Truthful Injection to Rayo, right in the middle of the Viva La Lucha ring. Oh! Mikey Truth gonna close in on the first pinfall for Norma's Mafia. 1, 2, and no, Rayo kicks out. And just shy of a month ago, SPW2K Heatwave, Mikey Truth was just competing against Rey Mysterio in a dream match, six-man tag, where Rey Mysterio is the step-in talent for the Lucha Natives, where down a man after Chavo Guerrero was attacked by mystery assailant. We've yet to know who the mystery hired gun is for Norma's Mafia. Clearly, he's the newest member, and this is his initiative. This is his initiation for the Mafia. He was put up to put that hit on the Chavo Guerrero, and he scored that. Chavo Guerrero has been injured indefinitely. Yet to return to SPW2K, Rayo Velezo has tagged in. Rayo Velez has tagged in to step up in place as the third man for the Lucha Natives. Complete this trio finally and hopefully their reoccurring teammate to complete this team. And the magic that the Lucha Natives have is that every teammate that has placed for them has worked wonders for their team, for success. But Frankie Graziano, who is the equal and common law right now to Apache Girl's size and weight advantage that he has over Norma's Mafia. Frankie Graziano meets him at that, and then some. But Apache Guerrero following away with that follow-away slam and that leg drop is crushing down on the throat of Frankie Graziano. Remaining control of this matchup, as this feud has built such intertwining stories between them. All six of these guys are talented stars in their own right. And look at this. Oh, here we go. A Three Amigo variation. Look at this. The power of Apache Guerrero. Frankie Graziano is a big dude, yo. And Apache Guerrero just threw him like a sack of potatoes. Nico Vega gonna meet him with the agility, being faster, more agile than Frankie. Frankie gonna try to ground and pound him. He's gonna set him up in that tree of woe, hooking those legs. And what is this? Backbreaker, oh my God, that code breaker. Just driving his spine and the vertebrae lining right through his knees. And look at this combination, the drive-by combination, the drive-by knee to end it off, that combo. Frankie Graziano, oh man, And I lay him out with the Graziano driver, dropping him with that brainbuster variation. Underarm hook, brainbuster variation on the knee. The Graziano driver scoring a pinfall for the team too. No, Nico Vega kicking out. Nico Vega, a town that has held multiple tag team championships, has held the most SPW2K tag team championships out of any talent on their SPW2K roster. Four-time SPW2K tag team champion, and now being the first ever SPW2K six-man tag team champion, he can be in the line right here and setting up Graziano for the pathway for the first time ever to be two-time six-man tag team champion. Here tonight with that Spanish fly, picture perfect, one, two, no, Graziano tosses him off like he's nothing. Nico Vega, homegrown talent, he's been a part of SPW2K since day one. Since we opened up the ground, we scouted talent throughout Mexico City, throughout little tours we did with Super Lucha Libre, but we found Nico Vega competing at a young 2DS age, at 19 years old. Groomed, he's matured over the years and become a promising talent for SPW2K, and here back home in Mexico City, as he's working down on Frankie Graziano, keeping Graziano away from his fellow Norman Mafia teammates Mikey Truth and Shane Ashton. And Graziano switching over in an Irish whip. Nico Vega and get away from the enemy territory. Bring Graziano. Graziano bringing Nico back to his home plate. Graziano now eating that boot as Nico gonna trade it back and bring Graziano back to his home plate. And the Lucha Native corner tagging in Ray. Rayo now dropping down on the arm, and you see the workings of this Lucha Native team. You had the team right there that spin out, Hernan Carano hooking the legs. No. It was a two. And Mikey Chu tags in. Graziano gets out a win. And Mikey with that clothesline. Knee hooking clothesline. High knee. Catching Ray. And now no, Rayo stopping him. Mikey comes about, working his weight over for a scorpion drop. Mikey can't really use his weight to his advantage with most of the guys on any roster promotion with his weight advantage being his height difference. But he can't use it here as he's working on that arm and forcing Rayo away from the rope to tap. Rayo tapping out. And Mikey scores the first pinfall for Norimorse Mafia. And you see Mikey wasting no time as the continuous bell rings, starting the second round. Rayo kicking out the face of Mikey Truth. Mikey with the over-under. Like I said, Mikey is usually the smaller dog in the fight. Here, he has the advantage over Rayo, and he's grounding him for another truthful injection. This is the second one for Rayo, and this could be all she wrote. This could be it. 2-0, right here. 1-2, and oh, Apache was there. Shane Ashton and Mikey working on Apache. Apache fighting back. Graziano now tagged in. And you can see Shane Ashton and Mikey Truth competing throughout COH. Mikey Truth now signing with XVPW. The Norimorse Mafia squad just continue to spread their wings throughout the car wrestling scene. Frankie Graziano now gonna drop this driver. Oh, just dropping Ray around his head, just annihilating Rayo. Apache back in for the save. And you can see Rayo's been decimated since that truthful injection. There's been no sign of life. Norimorse Mafia just need the space to finish off Rayo for that three count and walk out of here retaining. Oh my God, that body package, DDT. They can walk out of here retaining the six-man tag team champions. And Rayo finally back in control with a hurricanrana. Springing off the middle rope. Rayo now working on the knee. If I was Rayo, I'd try and drag. Find your way to finesse. Frankie back into your corner, tag out, and get back into breathing and controlling the overall beatdown that you suffered from Normos Mafia's corner. But oh, Rayo has a combo of his own as he grounds Graziano. Graziano stopping that kick, that wheeling kick, and he spins him up with that dragon screw. Graziano now tagging in the Colts, the Golden Boy, the Golden Boy, the cold, calculated Shane Ashton. They're trying to capitalize on Ray, but Rayo tilt roll. Reverse DDT setting up. Shane Ashton will be locked up between those legs. He drives his elbows to the face. And oh, hooking Rayo's legs. Shane's knocking to the head. Twisting away that mask. In a way, rearranging the mask, making it harder for Rayo to see. He's talking his shit. Shane Ashton. Oh man, gets his jaw jacked by Rayo. Rayo, oh, trying to throw that arm, but he got caught by Shane. Shane firing that forearm. And Shane talking his shit to Lucha Natives. Look at this. He's gonna confront Nico Vega there. And look at this. Clash with greatness. Face the greatness. Right there. Kill switch. Laid out. Normos Mafia corner. One. Two. No, Rayo. Rayo somehow, someway, still has life. If Normos Mafia really want, they can drain out the clock. There's 14 minutes into the match. And oh, a gold standard. Laying out Rayo. Or they can capitalize on that gold standard, flipping power driver. And Shane Ashton can capitalize and bring the tag team championships home. But Apache just slides in there, taking out not only Mikey Truth, but the referee. And Shane Ashton gonna capitalize another gold standard, damn near on the referee as well. And Shane, what are you doing? You know the referee's out. Trying to wake up the ref as he rolls Rayo into the middle of the rope. The middle of the squared circle, sorry. Away from the ropes. Shane Ashton going upstairs. Shane Ashton going upstairs. He's setting up Rayo for what? Crossbody. Rayo has been in bad, bad shape. He's taken an absolute beatdown. And that forearm just flooring Rayo. Shane Ashton tagging in Frankie Graziano. Shane Ashton has his three-way triple threat matchup at COH. We'll see him in action there. Shane Ashton just became UPW Global Heavyweight Champion. Almighty Truth became the first ever UPW Television Champion. Normos Mafia have been collecting gold throughout the car scene. Do not want to lose this SPV2K six-man tag team championship, as they just won it and defeated the Lucha Natives. They want to end this feud and add the insult to injury with a defeat, especially over an FMLL star like Rayo Velez. They want to defeat him. Score that pinfall, 2-0, and walk out of Mexico City. You may even have a riot if Normos Mafia gains the win here. They want to walk out of here with the win, beat Lucha Natives at their own game. Oh my God! Frankie Graziano just tossed Rayo like he was nothing, like he was a baby, like he was a damn child. And oh, Frankie attacks Apache, takes him off the apron. Rayo setting up Frankie in the corner. What is this? Tarantula. suplex. And that's not stopping Rayo there. Rayo, he hits it. Oh, my God. Going for the pin. One, two, and Mikey's there. Nico trying to attack Mikey. Mikey got out of dodge. What a match. We're shy of 10 minutes. Just over 10 minutes in to the finale of this Lucha Libre Rules 6-man tag team matchup. No More Mafia have one fall over the Lucha Natives. It's 1-0. Frankie Graziano just twerking and just wrenching the knee. Arreo just kicking away at the face of Frankie. Irish roots Frankie to the corner. Arreo go for the tag finally. Arreo finally gets the tag with Nico Vega. Nico Vega's in drop toe elbow to the spine of Frankie. Piercing the spine in the back of Frankie Graziano. That sends an electrifying volt through your body. Your fingers start to get all tingly, so your punches are weak. Your legs are wobbly. So your balance is off key. And oh man, beautiful standing Spanish fly. Nico Vega hits it beautifully. One, two, three. Nico Vega, he scored it and he tied it up. Norma's Mafia thought Frank was gonna kick out. You cannot doubt that maneuver. Frankie, his whole momentum was shifted. Equilibrium tilted. And Nico balanced the team. And it's 0-0. 9:30 in. 9 minutes, 30 seconds into this matchup. It's the final moments of this matchup. Both these teams have tied it up. Pinfall apiece. Nico Vega pinning Frankie Graziano, but Nico Vega eats that golden injection, that truthful injection variation at the hands of Shane Ashton, the golden boy, and the golden boy gets hooked. And you see Nico Vega doing the smart thing, tagging in Apache Guerrero, a man that has gotten the upper hand of Shane Ashton. And if anyone can trail away and get that pinfall or that winning submission attempt here tonight and gain that opportunity to become tag team, six-man tag team champions once again, it is Apache Guerrero to bring it home for the team. He did it in the six-man tag team tournament. He can do it here tonight. And oh, he drills Shane with the knee right on the skull. Apache drops Shane Ashton with that black hole slam in the middle of the squared circle. Apache driving that knee into the gut. Hooking up. Oh, slamming Shane Ashton into the mat. And Apache Guerrero. Shane Ashton hooking the legs. Gaining the momentum, Apache, oh man, that tree hook, forearm, right to the face. And Shane Ashton followed that zigzag. As Apache drags Shane Ashton to the middle of that squared circle, stomps him right in the face. What is he setting up for? Balancing off the rope to hit it with that knee into that neck breaker combination. Apache Guerrero walking around his territory. Smells the weakness in Shane Ashton and is ready to capitalize and bring it home for the team. But he may be taking too much time to work up a plan, his next arsenal, his next move set, his next attack to Shane Ashton. Oh, you're gonna bring it back to that black hole slam and ground him this time. Go for the pin. One, two, no. Shane kicking out. And you see how much that takes out of Shane Ashton to force himself out of that pinning predicament. It uses so much energy. And Apache Guerrero, spine busting. Can Apache watch a girl create history here tonight. Not only be the first time SPW six-man tag team champions already having that under your belt, but you're going to be the first ever team to hold the SPW 2K six-man tag team championships twice. Back to back. And look at this, that arrow hook. That bow and arrow hook submission he had basically set up on Shane Ashton. And look at this, Indian lock, Indian deathlock submission right there. Look at this, Shane Ashton has nowhere to go, he's tapping. That knee, he's working on the top of that knee. And Apache Guerrero scores it, he scores it. And we have you, new six-man tag team champion. As we go in to an SPW 2K Destiny Championship Showcase, we just crowned the new SPW 2K six-man tag team champion with the Lucha Natives. A beautiful, sweet home moment for the Lucha Natives. But right now, we're going into the SPW 2K Destiny Championship. The SPW 2K Destiny Championship title. Gonna be defended for the first time international soil, and for the first time in Mexico City, against FML All-Star Mikeli Afasiki. The Samoan bruiser making his way down. Afakasi, as I shuffling throughout these notes, I don't want this bruiser to tear my head off, so I better get his fucking name right. Mikeli, the Samoan bruiser, is probably the biggest threat throughout South America right now, and has all the eyes on him in his singles climb throughout the FMLL roster. He deserved this opportunity to a huge win on the FMLL tour. Granted, this shot is going to be cashed in with the SPW 2K Destiny Champion, Hypnosis. This man batting a little injuries from his war that he went with. The SPW 2K Destiny Champion, Hypnosis, went to war at SPW 2K Heatwave. Went to war with Nathan Smart, the SPW 2K World Champion, who will see in our main event. Who knows if the injuries suffered in that Extreme Rules war at SPW 2K will come into effect in his SPW 2K Destiny Championship defense. As now the table has been turned, Hypnosis has to defend the SPW 2K Destiny Championship on high profile matches, international interpromotional showcases like this. And this is a huge first defense, as you see the beautiful SPW 2K Destiny Championship Series tournament was concluded. That beautiful SBW2K Destiny Championship on the line here tonight as a Samoan bruiser. I like to call him Mekele Afakasi. You see that monstrous stare down to Hypnosis, the bandaged up Hypnosis, still suffering from rib injuries from his war with Nathan Smarta at Heatwave, the SBW2K Destiny champion, defending the title here tonight. Still has bandages from being busted open, but that's not stopping Hypnosis to appearing here in Mexico City, Mexico, Arena Mexico, and defending the SBW2K Destiny Championship for the first time outside of North America. And this is going to be the first defense for the SBW2K Destiny Championship outside of North America, outside of Canada, outside of the US, here on Mexican soil. Here we go, these guys locking up Hypnosis with that neck break on there. Early going, quickly locking into the locks of Mekele and hooking him in and dropping that knee into his head. Hypnosis now picking up Mekele now, locking it up. Oh, that arm drag, judo arm drag. The Samoan bruiser. Oh man, he's gonna have to use his strength, his power, and his brutal shoot style against Hypnosis. He's gonna be quick, he's gonna be agile, he's gonna be bouncing around this ring to get around this mammoth monster of a man as he tried to use that knee and it didn't take him down, stomped to the gut. And look at that, low arm drag, bringing down Mekele. All right, Kelly, back up. And oh man, just dropping that leg drop across the sternum and that kick to the ribs, and here we go. The onslaught of Mekele begins. Samoan bruiser with a vicious headbutt to the face. A Hypnosis. And oh, a kick to the ribs, and the Hypnosis still has to have this in the back of his mind that he has a huge matchup at Supreme Fest. Yes, Supreme Fest, our final major event for SBW2K on the 2K18 platform before we switch over to the 2K19 platform. Hypnosis will be competing against Call All-Star's own Call All-Star champion, Brandon Wolf. SBW2K Destiny champion versus the Call All-Star champion, and the Call All-Star championship will be on the line. But if Hypnosis can survive this fight against Mekele here tonight, or Mekele could be defending the SBW2K Destiny championship against Brandon Wolf, we could be seeing FMLL versus Call All-Stars at SBW2K Supreme Fest. That would be an interesting matchup. But you see, VHS has been set up, and Hypnosis is trying to make quick work and get out of here. One, two, no. Mekele kicks out. Hypnosis, I am not hating on Hypnosis at all. I'm trying to make quick work out of this matchup. Mekele is a huge, huge threat, and oh man, another shot to the face. Just trying to take off the head of Hypnosis. And the Samoan bruiser getting frustrated of the heart and the passion that burns inside of Hypnosis. And it took flaming tables, it took being crashed and burned through flaming tables to take out Hypnosis, and then being choked out to being passed out for Hypnosis to lose that heat wave against Nathan Smarta. Two, and no, Hypnosis kicks out here tonight, being dropped and bruised on those ribs. Those injured ribs by the Samoan bruiser, Mekele Afakasi. Mekele snake eyes his Hypnosis as he drags his carcass over to the rope. One, and oh, he's hooking the legs. And one, no, the ref sees. He's not gonna be tricked this time. Coastal scored a huge pinfall over Astrodynamico earlier in the night in that championship showcase. hooking those legs in the rope, the ref not allowing Afa Kasi to gain that upper advantage on Hypnosis there, not scoring the pinfall. And now Hypnosis with that high knee dropping McKelly. Afa Kasi shows to the mat, 1-2, no. McKelly throwing Hypnosis off, and Hypnosis thought that knee was the equation to a knockout there, and the equation to an equal pinfall 3-count predicament to send him with that ticket to Supreme Fest. Bell the belly slam, and McKelly slamming down on the ribs, and you see the pain oozing throughout the body, Hypnosis. And the longer this match goes, the more damaged those ribs are. And Hypnosis locking in that submission. No, McKelly has his legs on the ropes this time. That helps him. And it counts. Hypnosis perched up on the middle rope. Hypnosis not taking too much risk. As you see, he went for that cross body. McKelly, Afa Kasi to the outside, creating that space. Creating that space, ladies and gentlemen. He brings the fight to the inside of that ring. These guys are back inside the ring. The fans were raging on. Hypnosis locking up. The headlock, the fight brought back inside the squared circle. And Hypnosis launches back up to the outside as McKelly goes on the opposite side of the ring this time to try and create that space. And Hypnosis now taking the risk. He goes out there. Hypnosis, what are you doing? He's bringing out the table. We're in Mexico City, FMLL rules. There are no rules when you're on the outside. That table pushed up on the outside. Hypnosis launching McKelly to the floor, trying to create that space and get that upper advantage. Sending McKelly into the turnbuckle. Hypnosis slamming McCallie's face into the mat, unprotected floor. McKelly over under to Hypnosis, now picking up Hypnosis, hoisting him up. McKelly now, oh my God. Pop up Samoan driver to the outside. And that doesn't damage up the ribs. Maybe this table to the rib cage will, oh my God. Insult to injury. McKelly sent to the inside of the ring. Hypnosis climbing up. Springboard! Clothesline. And Hypnosis looking to bring in that table. Maybe the only equalizer to ground McKelly Afa Kasi, but this could flip. And this can cost him the SPW 2K Destiny Championship. McKelly, oh no, he tried to go for another Samoan drop. Back drop. He gets stopped with that Scorpion Death Drop. And Hypnosis, setting up the table. Hypnosis now, locking up McKelly. Oh, hooking him up. No, I thought he was gonna hook up those legs for the pin. They jock for position. Hypnosis trying to drill that elbow to the back of the head. Disorient McKelly. McKelly drip down. Eats that stone to the face. Eats the foot. And Hypnosis. Hypnosis punch the face to McKelly. And what is this? No. Oh, stone to the gut. Suplex. Oh my God, it's over. McKelly Afa Kasi. Oh my God, McKelly Afa Kasi just suplex. Hypnosis through the table. Instead of calling it quits, he's taking out another one. McCallie should have went for the pin right there. He just, that table just decimated, disintegrated under Hypnosis, and Hypnosis is panicking. Hypnosis is in panic mode. He goes for that clothesline bulldog. Picking up that table. Another table set up. And I think Hypnosis is getting second thoughts at that. The last time he set up that table, he was just thrown to it. Manhandled with that suplex to it. Even the hand time Hypnosis got out of that suplex before he crashed into that table was scary. And what is this? Hypnosis and McCallie into the table. What is this? Hypnosis. Hypnosis. T-Bone belly to belly overhead suplex. Folding McCallie. Oh my God. He folded him up. Look at McCallie fold up on his neck through the table. And Hypnosis. McCallie is laid out. McCallie is knocked out. He landed right on his head. Right on his head. As he's struggling to get back on his feet. Hypnosis. Oh, try to go for that draw kick. McCallie tried to drop down. Delayed on that. But Hypnosis is back up, flying forearm. And that bell, the belly overhead suplex did its damage to the neck of McCallie. And that, oh, McCallie grabbed the rope. He knows it did its damage. And Hypnosis sees an injured McCallie Afakasi from that bell to belly suplex. And oh, now what is this? Didi spiked him. He spiked him on the hardest part of the ring on the apron. Look at that. Oh my God. Hypnosis is giving McCallie a straight ticket to the hospital with a broken fucking neck here in Arena Mexico. You've seen these tables just decimated under these guys. And I don't know how McCallie Afakasi is still back up on his feet. Picking up that sledgehammer. Oh, he tried to drive it into the ribs of Hypnosis. Hypnosis charging back at him. McCallie Afakasi stopping that attack. That would just crush his ribs. Hypnosis working with bad ribs. A tweaked up hip. Lacerated forehead from his war at Heat Wave. He's now going through an extreme warfare again with McCallie Afakasi going through these tables. But it has not stopped Hypnosis. Hypnosis crossbodies to the outside. And I think he caught his arm on the steel step as well. Sending McCallie back into the apron, and McCallie went from trying to dominate Hypnosis to just being at equal now, if not being weakened by Hypnosis. From that, after that belly-to-belly overhead suplex, Hypnosis evened out this matchup. There was no way Hypnosis could have took another attack through that table. And Hypnosis is now decimating McCallie. He's setting up for another maneuver here. What is this? Hypnosis. Baseball slides through the turnbuckle. Just shooting right through the chest. Shooting right through the chest of McCallie Afakasi. McCallie, oh man, busted up. He ate that ring post, and that busted him right open. Hypnosis now upstairs. What are you doing? Just pandering to the crowd. Okay, I was like, Hypnosis, don't risk it. Don't do it, man. You have injured ribs and everything. Don't leap a fade dunk swanton off the turnbuckle, but he's gaining this fan up behind him. Arena of Mexico behind Hypnosis, the Destiny champion. Mikali Afakasi. Oh, nailing Hypnosis off the apron. Putting up that fight. Busted open and all. Oh, he tried to go for a forearm attempt, but he ate Hypnosis' forearm, beating him to punch, barely. Hypnosis back inside the ring. The crowd is on fire. Hypnosis, oh, springboard, is launching his body back. No care. Putting his own body on the line, using his own body as a pendulum swinging weapon to just ground the big man. And he sends Mikali Afakasi. He's gonna beat down this Timon Bruiser if he can close in on a VHS or a submission here tonight. He can definitely walk out of here with the SBW2K Destiny Championship with a successful defense. Hypnosis with that bulldog dropping Mikali, a busted open crimson mask that he is, and a swanton out of the corner. He hit it. Flight in motion by Hypnosis, and now Mikali is caught up in that submission. Ways away from the rope, and he's tapped out. Hypnosis did it. Hypnosis successfully defends the SBW2K Destiny Championship here at Viva La Lucha. And we look at the highlights here. These guys threw each other through these tables, and it was that right there. You see the twerk and the attacks. And Mikali off Lasica's head. Alasica tried to return the favor, but Hypnosis would meet him at every match and capitalize. The veteran, the legend that is Hypnosis, continues to live on, and his beautiful reign as the SBW2K Destiny Championship continues to be written in history. We'll see Hypnosis at Supreme Fest in the Adrenaline Finale show. And it's main event time, ladies and gentlemen. Six-man tag team finale to cap off a wonderful show here at Viva La Lucha. SPW2K team, Captain Nathan Smarta versus the FMLL team captain, Morta Firo. Here we coming out. Here we go. Coming out right now. The former SPW2K internet champion. Our very own SPW2K luchador. The pushy one. Mr. Coach, pushy baby, making his way down the aisle here in Arena of Mexico, Mexico City, ways away, a long way in here. Pushy baby, the fans immediately are in love with a pushy one. Who doesn't like some push? He smoked me on this before the show. Maybe that's why I was stumbling over the action throughout the show to hear today. It's all your fault, Fishy. And here we are. AWR's owner, Booker, head Booker, Cushy Baby, former SBW2K talent, gonna be teaming up with the FMLL prize possession, JC Rodriguez. JC Rodriguez has grown out here. JC Rodriguez has grown out here into Arena Mexico. FMLL being his home promotion. He's toured throughout Arena Mexico and has helped put FMLL on the map. And being one of these new generation luchador talents trying to make a splash in the international scene. This main event right here, all eyes are on him. Teaming up with two pillars of the SPW2K roster. This is a beautiful mix of our collaboration efforts with the FMLL brand. As you can see, SPW2K Talents team up with FMLL Talents. They cap off this six-man finale main event to end off here at Viva La Lucha. What a show it was. And you hear the symphony. We await the team captain of this team, the SPW2K World Champion, the reigning, defending SPW2K World Champion, Nathan Smarta. His symphony has gone. As we see the Blackbird, the ultimate Blackbird, arise here in Arena de Mexico. In Arena Mexico, the crowd here has erupted as they erate and they witness and they bask in the aura of the SPW2K World Champion Nathan Smarta. Nathan Smarta went to war with Hypnosis, who we've seen survive in his SPW2K Destiny Championship defense, but it's Nathan Smarta that took Hypnosis to a whole nother level at Heatwave. Nathan Smarta is the flagship man, the man here in SPW2K. He defeated Mikey Truth to become the SPW2K World Champion, and he's been unstoppable ever since, beating the likes of Pete Dunne, Hypnosis, multiple tours throughout various promotions throughout the Empire Wrestling Network, IFW, Rev Pro, FZW, OWF, you name the promotions in Empire Wrestling Network, Nathan Smarta has competed there and has raised the prestige of that SPW2K World Championship. Look at this team, a star-studded collection of SPW2K and FMLL talents alike. As we await the new generation of SPW2K, the newest signing to SPW2K, Trey Jeter. Looking to purge the empire, Trey Jeter, the new SPW2K internet champion. Trey Jeter, out here in Arena de Mexico, here in Mexico City for his first international tour with SPW2K. And Trey Jeter successfully grabbed down that SPW2K Internet Championship at Heatwave in that six-man Internet Championship ladder match, in which Cushy Baby had no other choice but watch from below as Trey Jeter grabbed that gold from the heavens to be crowned the SPW2K Internet Champion. And the addition of that team, you have Lance Slater, FMLL talent Lance Slater. The American import to Mexico City. Lance Slater has been a top talent throughout FMLL. He's been closing in on that Latin American Championship. Has went to war with JC Rodriguez in the past. These guys are like, is the next best thing for FMLL. The future's in either one of these hands. They're just looking for that moment to capitalize. And here Lance Slater has to put all that aside as he's going to team up with the FMLL Latin American champion and the SPW2K Internet champion and make that impression. Lance Slater from the States, good old USA, has made Mexico City and FMLL his home. As we await the arrival of a dark, dark soul, a tortured soul. Nathan Smart is our black bird, but the demon of Latin America is before us. This man is a Latin American champion, the FML Latin American champion, Morta Ferro. And he's making his entrance here, his presence felt. As he walks down that rampway in Arena in Mexico, where he went to war. He's had battles, blood baths for that world championship title. Tortured man deep down inside. And you see the beady red, the burning eyes under that mask. This is the interesting thing about this tag team matchup, is that this team is going to have to learn to work together and trust each other to score the win. Put their egos aside for the ultimate prize. And that's a W here to cap off Viva La Lucha, and our main event has started. Cushy Baby, Trey Jeter, they lock it up. Cushy Baby locking up with a straight jacket. Brain Buster to Trey Jeter. Cushy Baby finally getting his hands back on the Trey Jeter since the ladder match. And even in that ladder match, there were so many bodies involved in that six-man ladder match that he couldn't even focus on the man that went on that attack in the Destiny Championship Series, making his name known. Trey Jeter has been a man on a mission to make an example out of Legends of the Empire. Cushy Baby being the first one. And he is attacked with that spear, drilling him down to the matchup. In our main event matchup here tonight, Trey Jeter now perched up on the squared circle, aiming for that swanton on Cushy Baby out of that middle rope. Empty pool there. Cushy Baby answering an uppercut, dropping Trey Jeter. Trey Jeter being dragged over to enemy territory with JC Rodriguez being tagged in. JC Rodriguez, Trey Jeter for the first time competing. And this is the first time we're seeing these talents team up together or compete against each other. Hear this squared circle. And we'd like to thank all you for tuning in for Viva La Lucha. We'd like to thank the team here at FMLL for making this happen. This is a legendary and historic moment for the card wrestling scene. Two card promotions coming together to collab on an event like this is always great for the business, great for the scene, and opens opportunities alike for all talent on an international scale. Trey Jeter setting up for stalling. Suplex, it looked like. Look at this. He's squatting down on JC Rodriguez, showcasing his arsenal and his skill set, his abilities. Trey Jeter behind the All-Star Extravaganza with WWA. It's going to be 5 days back-to-back card wrestling action. Bigger, better, and better than ever before. But here tonight, he has to focus on making that impression, teaming up with the heels at FMLL. He tags in Lance Slater being the only non-champion on his team. He's looking to make an impression, but he ate that forearm by JC Rodriguez. And oh, JC Rodriguez, one step ahead. Lance Slater, oh, eats that fisherman hook. Suplex. Even missed a perfect run for his money in that super kick. JC Rodriguez flooring Lance Slater. Lance Slater picking up JC Rodriguez. Lance Slater would like to defeat JC Rodriguez. Set up a number of contendership opportunity against his teammate here tonight, Mortifero, for that FMLL Latin American World Championship title. And you see three amigos here. With all due respect to Rodriguez in tribute to Eddie Guerrero. And he hooks the leg for an extra insult to injury. Lance Slater crossing off Jason Rodriguez to make an attack, but Jason Rodriguez answers back with an armbar, wrenching armbar into the mat. Lance back around, attack to the back. Lance Slater, pump hole slam backbreaker to JC Rodriguez. And Cushy, oh no, it was Nathan Smart that got the tag. Nathan, oh, he eats that DDT. Lance Slater. And this, if Lance Slater was to get a pinfall over Nathan Smart, we'd have to give him that ticket. Come on over to the Adrenaline Finale. Get that World Championship opportunity over Nathan Smarter before Supreme Fest. Nathan Smarter's match for Supreme Fest has yet to be announced. That could have been a match for Supreme Fest as well. What is this? Lance Slater stomping into the gut of Nathan Smarter. Lance Slater is not being starstruck of the world champion at all. He's bringing the fight to Nathan Smarter with that backbreaker. First time these guys have ever clashed in that squared circle before. Nathan Smarter scaling back around. Backdrop, dropping Lance Slater right on his back. And Nathan Smarter is a dangerous, dangerous wrestler. He's a sharpshooter in that squared circle. Any weakness, any opening, he'll cash in for that victory. And oh, that neck breaker was nasty and stiff. And oh, Lance Slater hooking him up with that belly-to-belly follow-away slam. Damn, they're tangling him up into the ropes there. Mexico, more loose and give to the ropes here in Mexico. The ring mat is definitely more thicker and harder than in Canada and in the US. The guys with 2K talents are more used to working, so being dropped in this mat definitely brings that shock factor to your body. As Nathan Smarter just grounding down Lance Slater. And you see what Nathan Smarter is doing, he's crossed off the ring. Created that imaginary line where there's no way for Lance Slater to get back to his teammates. And that black mask whipping Blackbird kick knocked out Lance Slater 2-0. Lance panicking to kick out of that. But Nathan Smarter maybe setting up for the conclusion here. Look at this, the submission right here. Look at this, he's gonna choke him out. Choke him out right here in Mexico City. Lance Slater's gonna tap. You have no choice. And Lance Slater taps out. Nathan Smarter brings the win for his team. Nathan Smarter, JC Rodriguez, the Cushy Baby, defeat Lance Slater, Mortifero, the FMLL Latin American World Champion, and the SPW2K Internet Champion, trade you to eat this defeat under the hands of Lance Slater tapping out. And that kick to the face. Look at that, game changer. He hit it perfect, right in the temple, knocking out Lance Slater. Lance Slater kicking out was just panic attack. It was just a panic, you see, too. And he kicked out right there, panicking, and then boom, he got caught. And you see, Nathan Smarter, ring general, cuts off the ring. Nowhere for Mortifero and Trajan to run in and break it up at least. They're allowing Lance Slater to fight it or try to find a way to get out of that submission, but he was caught up. Nowhere to get to the ropes. Nowhere to grab the ropes. Nowhere to place his legs on the ropes. He was caught up. Distance, ring awareness, all there for this wonderful team. And it's a win for Nathan Smarter, SPW2K World Champion, JC Rodriguez, the FMLL star, and Cushy Baby, the Cushy One, Cushy Baby, Mr. Cush. This is a win, and we'd like to thank you all for watching. Viva La Lucha. Thank you, FMLL, and thank you all for tuning in. This was SPW2K. We'll see you at the Adrenaline Finale season finale and Supreme Fest 2018 will call all stars. See you at the matches.
2018 Two Colors, the best way to see a collab showcase our stars of the community. Introducing from the featured matches box, SCW 2K Women's World Champion Emily has issued out an invitation to any top female wrestler to accept a championship showcase at Supreme Star Calling Out and Call Wrestling to step in. The ring with the baddest bitch. The SBW 2K Internet Championship will be defended featuring the 12 Cosmonslip match, including caught talents from SBW 2K, All Stars, and the Car Wrestling scene. The last entrant will be the current SBW 2K Internet Champion, who will act as the title match upon entry in the match. At Supreme Fest, we see All Stars Tag Team Champions in his rush hour. A Jay Young and Jay Crack will battle SBW 2K Tag Team Champions. The co-main event in 2018 has been announced. Call Stars Championship match, the current champion Brandon Wolf defends the gold against SBW2K Destiny Champion Hypnosis. Supreme Fest 2018 will continue to roll out the match card closer to showtime, so stay subscribed to the channel to keep up with the action. I'm Vicky Santiago, this is the Event Center, and we will see you at the matches.
Yo! Easy. Okay, straighten. My enemies leave faceless. Can't slip, can't leave no traces. Put faith in the books like Mason. Gracious, I found truth in statements. Found self on distant stages. Man can't tell me about patience. Spent nights in the darkest places. Man can't tell me about grind. 10 toes put holes in trainers. Can't parlay with pagans. Old friends now distant strangers. Old money make new friends later. Long time since minimum wages. Long time since man has seen angels. Like wait, where? Okay, you're bad now, cool. Young boy move like man at old school. Geez, I know, so they don't know you. So we roll through your ends like man a low cool. Like, okay, you're bad now, cool. Go on and do what a bad man do. I know geez that will test that gangster. Make man lean that criminal smooth. Like, whoa, mic to mouth, check to check. And I still go city to city repping the set like.